has been reported more and more frequently each and every week. It's unbelievable. We are being sent videotapes. The phone is ringing off the hook. Everybody seems to be seeing The Undertaker. I have not seen him. Ted claims he's seen him twice. I know one person who hasn't been seen. Hasn't been seen at all. That is Mr. Perfect. Mr. Perfect has failed to show up on the WrestleMania Revenge Tour. And we here at the World Wrestling Federation want to apologize for Mr. Perfect's indiscretions. And President Jack Tunney has had no choice but to suspend Mr. Perfect indefinitely because he has failed to meet his contractual obligations. My personal opinion is that Mr. Perfect is scared of Lex Luger. This is one man here, Quang, who is not scared of anybody. He gave the Hitman everything he could handle on Raw. Oh, he is impressive. What do you think?
Well, this is one time, Lane, that I'm going to have to agree with you. And I've been talking about this guy and praising him ever since they've seen him come to the World Wrestling Federation. He's done a tremendous job. And, hey, Harvey Whippleman, what can you say about him? He always seems to produce a winner time after time after time.
Not only does he have Quang in his stable, but also the most impressive Adam Bomb from that 6'9", 330-pound mark. And, yes, you're right, Harvey Whippleman, I don't like him. He runs his mouth continuously, but you have to agree, he does have some very, very adept talent in his stable. As we see Quang facing off this week against Major Yates. I wonder if he's in the Army.
I don't know.
Well, he's getting ready to go to probably boot camp right here because Quang is known for his fast starts and already a knife-edge chop to the chest. Oh, look at that hook kick. Oh, put Yates right down. What's he doing here?
I don't know.
Holding his throat. Oh, my, there's that green.
There it again.
What is that stuff? Is that
I
green
have no
mist?
Idea.
Every week. And here it comes floating down on top of us again as Quang is putting the chops to Major Yates.
Man, that's nasty. The only green I like floating down on me is money.
Yeah, I can imagine. Major Yates been sitting in for the right. Oh, caught Quang right there with a kick. And now Quang being Irish whipped into the ropes. Big drop kick by Yates puts Quang down to both knees.
But he can't seem to take him off his feet, Lane. Look at that.
Yes.
Two clotheslines, he won't go down.
Series of clotheslines, staggered Quang, that's about it. Ducks under a clothesline there. Wow, that's a spinning crescent kick. Oh, nicely done, Quang. Going for cover here. Hooks a leg and he's got him.
What a tremendous move.
Wow. Major Yates fights the dust here this week.
Quang.
And Harvey Whippleman with a smile etched across his face. He likes what he sees.
Just like me, Lane, he likes to see a winner. And this guy, you know, that takes a lot to impress.
Look at this. What's Harvey doing here? Come on, referee, step in there. That little weasel. I can't believe. Oh, look. Yates has his legs. Oh, this could be disaster for Harvey. Look. Quang steps in. Major Yates had the ankle of Harvey Whippleman.
Major made a big mistake.
Now, look at this. Oh, now, come on. Oh,
this is getting better by the moment.
Harvey removing his jacket, that size, extra small jacket, takes his tie on it. Come on now. This is uncalled for.
Wait a minute. What's he doing here? Come on now.
He's stepping for action next, but he's came a little early. And now you're on the scene. Oh, look at that kick.
Get him out of here, referee.
Spinning back kick. Puts Quang right out of the ring.
He's got no business down here, Lane.
Oh, the 1-2-3 kid is the one person who can match Quang move for move in the martial arts department.
He's going to get himself in trouble. He keeps sticking his nose in other people's business.
The kid just saved Major Yates from a severe beating, probably. Yes, sir. Get back in there, Quang. I love it. The kid saves the day.
Hey, it's 6:30 in the morning, and I don't mind getting these hands dirty. I take pride in cleaning up these streets, just like I'm going to clean up the WWF. So watch out, Double J. And watch out, Yokozuna. Because the dumpster is coming soon. Let's go.
Well,
he says he's going to show you what he can do, you can bet that he will. You can put it in the bank, because ever since he beat his brother at WrestleMania 10, he's done just that. He's shown everybody.
He said he'd do it, and certainly he did do it. But that was not a title match, if you recall, at WrestleMania 10. It will be title matchups during the entire worldwide WrestleMania Revenge Tour. Can the Rocket take the gold from his brother Bret? I personally don't think so.
Well, I've said it once, I've said it 1,000 times. I'm predicting that we'll have a new champion, Owen the Rocket Hart, and you can take that to the bank, Wayne.
I'll tell you what I will take to the bank. That's the comments coming up shortly here this week. The comments from the WWF champion Bret the Hitman Hart, and that exclusive interview with Johnny Polo coming up here shortly. But now, this arena is getting ready to crank. They're going to blow the roof off the sucker as Oscar leads the way down the aisle for Mo in singles competition this week, facing the Rocket Owen Hart.
Oh, look at that.
Would you care to make a prediction about this upcoming matchup?
I mean, isn't it obvious to you, Wayne? Does a prediction have to be made? This is the Rocket Owen Hart's match, without a doubt. He'll be the winner.
Well, I don't know about that. You know, Mo, one half of the former WWF Tag Team Champions, he's up close to that 300-pound mark. And the question on my mind, Ted, is can the Rocket Owen Hart put a sharpshooter on the squash? But look at the size of his legs. He may not be able to get the sharpshooter on there.
He can do it. And what a useless point you make, one half of the former World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions.
Well, they won.
I mean, oh, yeah, for 2 days. It's not even worth mentioning.
They won the tag team belts off the Quebecers in the Worldwide WrestleMania Revenge Tour. And as Ted stated, they lost them 2 days later. But still, they had the belts. They were the champions. That's all that matters.
Well, let's see what happens right here.
Single action coming up here. This is a match we've looked forward to. Mo taking on the Rocket, Owen Hart. And you know, Mo's partner, Mabel, will also be seeing some singles competition in the upcoming weeks, too, I understand. A little verbal confrontation here already. There is no love lost here between these two. Look at the Rocket. So methodical. Always thinking in there. They lock up collar and elbow, and the Rocket gets a taste of the power of Mo. Mo shall be right back, Ted.
Yeah, well, I'll tell you what. This is the first time that I've seen them separate without being in a tag team situation. What's Mo going to do without his big 500-pound partner, Mabel?
Well, that might be a good point. You know, they have almost wrestled exclusively tag team, but, hey, they're both very, very accomplished athletes. And I'm looking forward to this. I think Mo is going to do very, very well for himself. Look at this. Series of shoves. Oh, my gosh. The Rocket just slapped Mo right across the face. And look at this. Look at the Rocket. Big, tough guy ducking under the rope to avoid the confrontation with Mabel after he slapped him.
That's not it, Wayne. That's called psychology. Psyching him out. That's exactly what he's doing. He's making him mad. He's going to make him mad to the point where he forgets about anything but trying to get revenge.
Mabel windmilling the arm of the Rocket. Working on the joint, the elbow joint, reversal by, listen to this crowd. It's deafening. We want Bret. Oh, yeah, they want to see it. And they will see it on the Revenge Tour.
Well, I don't think they'll be screaming they want to see it after they do see it. They'll be sorry they asked for it because you're going to have a new champion.
Series of hammerlock reversals here. Both men testing out the expertise of the other, matching hole for hole so far here in this confrontation.
Well, Mo's making
a drop toehold there by the Rocket.
Like I said.
Into a side headlock. But look at there. Back into the hammerlock. Drives the knee into the rear tricep muscle. Trying to wear that arm down, weaken it. Perhaps go for a submission.
Even though he may have the advantage at the moment. Mo trying to match move for move and skill for skill with Owen Hart is a big mistake.
Well, certainly Mo not as quick, not as fast as a Rocket, but he's got to be more powerful, Ted.
Well, the power may be the only thing he has to his advantage. And I tell you what, in the
back
long
into the corner, look at there.
You're going to see
Mo took an elbow right to the face.
You're going to see that it'll be to his disadvantage.
Now the Rocket opening up a little bit on Mo. Series of rights there. Reversal into the ropes. Mo drops down. What's going to happen here? Oh, nice. Hip lock takeover. Well, did you see that arm drag? Did you see the way Mo spun into that and torqued the arm? See, the faster you spin, the more torque you put on there, and he just whipped the Rocket over. Nicely done. You want to talk about matching hole for hole? What about that move?
Well, you sound like you're some kind of expert, huh?
Doesn't get any better than that.
Yeah.
Moa's got the arm one more time, and he is working on it.
Who did you ever beat?
You got about an hour, and I'll tell you about it. Into the turnbuckle one more time. Referee calling for a break. Took a boot right to the midsection. And now the Rocket pounding on Mo. Mo down to one knee now. Come on, referee calling for the break here. He's not getting it. Oh, look at that.
There you go.
The Rocket raking the face of Mo across that top rope. That will definitely stop you right in your tracks.
That's it. Run his hand into that turnbuckle. Hey.
The Rocket backing Mo into the ropes and shoots him off there. Look at that. Oh, spinning kick there. Didn't have a lot of momentum on it, but nevertheless put Mo down.
Mo at the moment has no momentum at all, Lane.
Going for a modified camel clutch here. He has one arm up over the knee for that leverage. And Mo puts his other up there to take the pressure off that right shoulder. That definitely hurts. That's almost a submission type move there. It also works the lower back. Referee asking Mo, there's no way in this lifetime Mo's going to give it up, I'll tell you that. He's got a heart as big as Texas. Drives an elbow into the midsection of the Rocket. Hits the ropes, comes up, ducks the clothesline, hits the far ropes, oh, cut a knee.
Don't count your chickens before they're hatched, Wayne.
Once again, this place is going crazy.
I think he's going for it.
They want Brett.
No.
Ted thought he maybe set him up for that sharpshoot. I don't think Mo has been worn down nearly enough for that. Look, he's going to do it again. Oh, look at that. Shoved off there, kicked into the turnbuckle. Big backdrop. The Rocket charged Mo, and he paid the price. Mo took him up and over. And now Mo's the big right.
Another one.
The Rocket reeling and rocking. See there, Ted? Anything could happen in this matchup. Inside cradle now. And he hooked pretty good, but the Rocket managed to power out.
Take a lot more than that to get the Owen
down. Look at this.
There you go. There you go. Great move.
Hard side stepping it. Oh,
great move.
Came down hard on his knee, it looked like to me. He also hit the outside steel retaining fence.
Come on, Owen. Go after him.
Uh-oh. This could be trouble.
Go after him, Owen. Come on.
Oscar checking on the condition of Mo. He went out hard and came down on those mats and appeared to twist his knee. You know, Ted, I've never been a fan of those outside.
Where's Oscar going?
When you land on those mats, they tend to shift and move, and sometimes you can throw a knee out. And I certainly hope this hasn't happened here.
Get him off the ring. What is this?
Mo is hurt.
Throw in the towel.
Mo definitely hurt.
Oh, throw in the towel.
What a travesty of justice here.
Oh, come on.
This is a shame. I think Mo is ahead on points. If he can't continue, this is terrible. I hate to see this.
Come on, throw in the towel, Oscar. He's done. He's finished.
Obviously, he has hurt that.
Gentlemen, the referee has informed me that Mo is unable to continue to wrestle. Therefore, the winner of this match, the Rocket, Owen Hart.
Excellent.
Mo is in excruciating pain right here. He is holding the right knee. I certainly hope he hasn't torn any ligaments or tendons in that knee, but he is definitely hurt.
Okay.
He can't even make his feet. He can't even get up.
Oh, it just breaks my heart. Hey. What are you going to say now? There it is, right there. One picture's worth a million words.
Oh, I certainly hope he can get up.
I couldn't have said it better myself.
The Rocket, what's that? Oh, no, no, no.
That's it,
oh. Oh, stop it, referee.
Yes.
No, no, he's working on more outside the ring. The match was over.
Come on. That's it. Throw him back in or give him a little more.
Oh, this is terrible.
Punish him.
He's already hurt.
Punish him.
Enough's enough here.
No,
come on.
No. That's not enough.
He's working the knee.
Yeah.
This is terrible.
That's
I hate to see this. Oh, no. Look at this. Oscar, get in there. Do something.
That's it. Put it on him.
Oh,
that's
Put
it on him. That's right.
He's got the sharpshooter on him. No, he turned him over.
That's what you call teaching somebody a lesson.
Oh, this is terrible.
That's
no.
It. Yeah. He's crying. Look at him cry.
Do something, referee. We need some help out here.
Yeah, he needs help, all right. They'll never mess with him again.
Mo in tremendous pain here. Oh, he had that knee injured, and now the sharpshooter's working on that very injured, hurt knee.
Listen to him squeal.
Referee's coming out here trying to break the hold.
Hey, get Oscar out of there. What are you going to do, Oscar?
I can't believe the Rocket's doing this. There's no
sure right now that this guy never sticks his nose in his face again.
Oh, no, this is horrible. He finally released the hole.
Now,
whoa, there it is! There it is. You want a little bit? I'll take your title, I'll stick your pride, and I'll beat you just like I did before, brother. I ought to be the champion.
There you go.
Yeah, hey, talk is cheap.
Now there is a man on a mission.
He may have been able to put the sharpshooter on a man who had an injured knee, but I say he'll never do that to his brother, the WWF champion, Bret the Hitman Hart. And speaking of Bret Hart, we'll be back with a special interview with the champ.
I wish it was you.
Ladies and gentlemen, my next guest is the World Wrestling Federation Champion, Bret the Hitman Hart!
Oh, yeah! Everybody's on their feet for the champ!
Well, I tell you what,
Ted. Everybody? I haven't left my seat.
Well, I stood up, and every man, woman, and child in this arena did, too. Look at them. They love the Hitman. I'll tell you what. When the Hitman gets his hands on his brother, he's going to pay.
WrestleMania tour. You're talking about the Hitman.
Here's Owen. What's he doing?
You're
the one who wants revenge. I forgot, because you're the one who suffered that humiliating defeat at WrestleMania 10 to your brother. However, the next time you two face, when he defeats you, he will become the next World Wrestling Federation champion.
You know, it was just one match. And I don't need any excuses, but I will say this much. Owen, you're a great wrestler. You've always been a great wrestler, and I'll never deny that from you. But I will say this much. Sometimes what doesn't kill you makes you that much stronger. And after that humiliating loss to my brother Owen, back in the dressing room at WrestleMania 10, I could feel it. Deep down inside, I got stronger and stronger and stronger. And Owen, I think deep down inside, you helped me win the World Wrestling Federation Championship belt. You made me realize that I was slacking off in your case. Maybe because you're my brother, I cut you just a little slack. I don't know, but I will say this much. I never ever said I was unbeatable until now. Owen, when you step in the ring with me on the WrestleMania Revenge Tour, mark my words, brother, you'll be stepping in the ring with the best there is, the best there was, and the best there ever will be.
Wait a second. Keep the noise down. Let me get one last question out, Bret. Those words you just spoke, how does it feel when your own brother Owen says that he is the best there is, the best there was, and the best there ever will be, with such total and utter conviction?
Put up to that, Bret. I want to hear a response.
Don't be fooled by cheap imitations.
Samoans before their hats, big man.
I don't know about that signaler. Here for the tower once again. Tag is made. Legal man is Pierre. We've seen this before. A devastating maneuver from the top rope. Here comes Pierre. Yes. No. Moving out of the way. Just in the nick of time. Samo but Johnny Polo smacks down. Albano, but Johnny Polo holds him. Oh, my goodness.
He's been emphasized.
Offa just let Johnny Polo have it. But here comes the tag. Here comes Pierre. Wait a minute. Here comes Fatu as well. Two freshmen in there. The referee didn't see it. Oh, no.
Walk him up and throw away the key.
Double team it. No. A forearm that caught Pierre right in the mush by mistake.
We're getting down to the nitty gritty right now for the titles.
Pierre and John. Oh, wait a minute. Did you see that?
Check that out.
Unbelievable. Pierre just nailed his own tag team partner.
On
You've
purpose.
Got to get along. Yes, we talked about tag team coordination before. Chuck and Pierre having it out here on Monday Night Raw. What a stupid thing to do.
Real stupid. Little miscommunication could cost them the titles right there.
Now, it's up to Jacques to get over and tag Pierre. Meanwhile, the tag is made and Fatu's back in. Fatu and Sam. Oh, no. Oh, no. Look at this. Double team down. They almost buried Jacques. Look at that. Pierre is knocked off the apron.
The head triggers aren't letting up, brother. They're going for it all.
Up under the top rope now. It's Samu back to the corner. Fatu off the top and down. One, two, yes.
They got it. They got it.
Look at this place.
It's over.
Burlington, Vermont. The setting for Monday Night Raw. The setting for the tag team championship changing of the guard.
I got goosebumps on top of goosebumps.
It took a long, long time, but nonetheless, yes, the head triggers did what they had to do. They became tag team champions here tonight on Monday Night Raw.
It's not over till it's over, but it's over now, and it's party time.
Oh, yeah, Captain Louis Albano is thrilled with himself. Stand by for a special King of the Ring report, after which we'll give you more action.
And all I hear is Yokozuna, Yokozuna, Yokozuna. When am I going to take on Yokozuna? So I'm telling you something, Yokozuna. I'm challenging you to a match. I'm challenging you one for one, man to a match. And this match will not only show everybody who the biggest man in the World Wrestling Federation is, but who's the best?
Oh, yeah!
You moms out there, yes, happy Mother's Day.
Number. king.
That's right. But there is only one undisputed king of the World Wrestling Federation, and I, Vince McMahon, am that king.
Yeah, right. Bret Hart won the King in the Ring tournament last year. And, of course, you crowned him, so to speak. You're going to pay for that. Look at this. Right now, it's Scott Steiner against RS. Steiner coming off the ropes. And arm drag to the rope on the far side. Over the hip. Nicely done by Scott Steiner. Steiner with a scoop. Steiner with a slam. And now,
oh, double underhook. RS is going to go for the rock. Oh, and
down to the canvas. What a maneuver by Scott Steiner.
I can't believe Scott Steiner's starting off this fast. I thought he's supposed to be a tag team wrestler.
And look at this. Right on the outside. And if he's counting out, he is history. He will not advance. He will not participate in the King of the Ring tournament.
You mean you're knocked out if you get counted out?
It doesn't matter how you lose. If you lose,
look at this.
You're out. Oh, no.
Well, he should be disqualified then.
They caught him a tax cheat.
IRS. No, you can't run somebody's head into the metal steps and then let him get counted out in a match as important as this.
IRS trying to clear the cobweb. IRS in a bit of trouble.
No,
and there's
there
no sympathy at all from this capacity crowd, I'll assure you.
Possibly do. What are you talking about now?
Talking about IRS and the Native American Tatanka. When IRS on Monday Night Raw took the sacred headdress of Tatanka and destroyed it.
I'm telling you, listening to you and sitting here looking at you, you remind me of one of Tatanka's famous ancestors. Sitting bull, because that's all it is, a bunch of bull. He did exactly what he should have done.
Erwin R. Scheister continuing the assault. And escape there by IRS.
Come on, IRS.
Scott Steiner and IRS evenly matched as far as scientific skill is concerned. There he is. Take that.
Oh, but Scott Steiner stays right with it.
You can bet that just about every WWF superstar in the land is looking on watching this matchup. They all want to be part of the King of the Ring tournament. Speaking of looking on, now's a good time if you want, if the cameraman can... There's the king. That's
there
the
we
first
are.
Side of the king. There you
what
are,
you
king.
Mean?
You're looking great this week, king. I've got to say. And so is Scott Steiner.
Kick
the
out.
Man. Oh, so close.
Man. I don't know if Erwin R. Scheister knows about my royal prognostication on this.
Yeah,
he cannot let me down.
Maybe you should send him a note. Pony Express.
Well, here, I'll write it. You take it down to the ring.
Shoulder up. Oh, Scott Steiner almost pinned himself.
Oh, and wait a minute. Wait a minute. You're totally biased in this.
I'm not biased. I'm calling the action.
You were pulling for Scott Steiner. It's obvious.
And you're not pulling for IRS, are you?
No, I'm totally.
Yeah. Your picture wasn't up on the screen. You weren't called one of the top three tax cheats this week.
That's because I'm not.
Yeah, because you pay your taxes, right?
That's exactly right.
Because you're a model citizen, right?
That's right, and I'm a king. And this match is to determine who gets into the King of the Ring tournament. There's two guys there, one of which, who happens to be standing right now, would be deserving of that title. The other one, it would be a disgrace if he were even in the tournament, much less be crowned a king.
IRS misses on the elbow. Scott Steiner, quick go behind and a takedown.
Come on, Erwin.
Erwin doesn't quite know what to do with the skills of Scott Steiner. And Scott Steiner proving one thing thus far in the matchup, that he's every bit as competition as compared to tag team.
Well, that's what I can't believe. I would have thought he'd been totally lost
without his brother. And one hits it almost a count of three.
What kind of hold is that?
An effective one. And Irwin spinning into his man, looking for the escape. Scott Steiner staying right with that left shoulder. Feet now. Erwin R. Scheister trying to make a move. Abdominal stretch. Trying to wrap it up here. Scott Steiner applying more pressure.
You're not going to get Erwin to give up.
And a hair pull from our vantage point.
Look at that. Look at the ropes.
He is holding onto the rope. That's true.
Disqualifying referee.
The official does not see it. And
let me ring the bell.
Erwin is going to give up.
I'm telling you, I'm disqualifying him.
No. Scott Steiner fighting fire with fire.
Become kings, but they're not really kings. Elvis Presley, for instance, they called him the king. Just a nice guy, from what I hear, whole lot of talent. But he really wasn't a king. Tired to be honest with you, I'm gonna tell you the bottom line here, Jerry the King Lawler. I'm getting tired of people asking me about you and your snotty-nosed little comments, bottom line. I got nothing to prove. Let me get this straight, Lawler. You did what? You called a bunch of kids in the hospital for sick children in Toronto. You go there and you call them brats? Is this what you're doing to try to get me to fight you? Okay, Jerry the King Lawler. I'm gonna fight you.
One more time, I'm gonna fight. Here we go. One more time, only this time. The women's go to the hospital for sick children in Toronto. In other words, you don't win, you don't get nothing. Don't you understand why folks avoid me? You know why? Because I don't take no dives. And I don't do windows. I don't retreat. And I don't surrender. You've crossed the bottom line. Welcome to my world.
Everybody's got a price for the $1 million man. If I've said it once, I've said it a million times. And over the years here in the World Wrestling Federation, I've proved it time and time again. And I'm going to prove it to you again right now. So I'm going to introduce to you my latest purchase. That's right. He's a man who you all know here in the World Wrestling Federation. He's a former superstar of the World Wrestling Federation. But he now works for the $1 million man, not because he wants to, but because he has no choice. I give you Nikolai Volkov. Well, Nikolai Volkov doesn't even like me. You don't like me, do you, Volkov?
I hate your guts.
This proud man has a family. He has a wife and children. He has a mortgage that's months overdue. His kids need new shoes. They need new clothes. They need a decent meal on the table, don't they, Nikolai? That's right. He is now the property of the $1 million man because he has no choice. Because I have the power. And the power is Nikolai Volkov, the almighty dollar. You'd love to just knock my nose off, wouldn't you, Volkov?
Don't push me too
You'd
hard.
Love to just spit in my face, wouldn't you, Nikolai? You can't stand me. You hate me. But you won't do it. You know why, Nikolai? Do you nickel and dime peons know why? Because you don't bite the hand that feeds you. Come on, Volkov. 3 feet behind me.
The Hitchhikers 10 are the new WWF Tag Team Champions.
Yeah, and I think it's absolutely disgusting. I said it at the top of the show. I'll say it again. It's a travesty of justice. Lee Albano comes down and rips off Johnny Polo. Slides him into this deal. It's an underhanded deal to begin with. The match shipments have never taken place. And, I mean, look at the Hitchhikers. No doubt they're unpredictable. No doubt that they're tremendous athletes. But they're savages. They're the champions now. And they're going to make all this money. I mean, do they even know what to do with money?
Who really cares? They have the gold around their waist. And, you know, from looking at them.
How could you say something like that?
I would imagine they need money. Can you imagine their grocery bill every week? It's got to be outrageous. More grass leggings or some more, hey, who knows? All I know is this. They are the champs, and I think it's well-deserved.
You smell sardines?
Gosh, I didn't know what that was. That's sardines?
Gosh, that's disgusting.
You know what I just did earlier, Ted?
What's that, Lane?
I sent a greetings on call to my mom, Jean. Yes, this weekend, the Macho Man, Randy Savage, is calling my mom, wishing her a happy Mother's Day.
Disgusting.
Well, I guess they were still hungry. Guess the sardines didn't fill them up enough.
Oh, please.
Jim Cornette is incensed. He can't believe it. Well, they took a bite out of the heavenly bodies.
You can say that again.
again.
Well, the doctor up his hire, and Gigolo Jimmy a little tentative now about stepping back into the ring with Luke and Butch. I told you these guys will do anything to win. They're kind of like
anything but take a shower.
They're kind of like McGruff. They take a bite out of crime.
Oh!
Heavenly Body's opening up now on them. Got them in opposite turnbuckles. What's this going to be here? Driving a couple of right fists. I think you're setting them up for something. Oh, do-si-do!
Sam Lane, I got a point going up here. Rowdy Roddy Piper is finally going to have to put his money where his big mouth is and step into the ring with the King, Jerry Lawler. This thing's been going back and forth and back and forth. Now it's time to put up or shut up.
Well, Jerry Lawler, the King, went too far when he started knocking the children's hospital. I mean, you have to draw the line somewhere, D.B. See, I think Rowdy Roddy Piper is a man of superlative integrity and class. I mean, he's even offered, if he wins that matchup at King of the Ring against Jerry the King Lawler, he's going to donate part of his purse to the hospital for sick children. I think that's just a fantastic thing to do.
Oh, well, I'm so impressed. Well, if he's such a great guy, if he's so generous, why doesn't he donate his entire purse to the children's hospital? You know why? Because he can't afford it.
Well, hey, speaking of affording things, you know, you're a man who's always bragging about his wealth. You take out that fat checkbook of yours, Ted, and write out a nice big one to the hospital for sick children. I think that'd be a good cause.
Hey, you know what, Lane? I write checks to my favorite charity all the time. Yeah. My retirement fund.
Well, the Bushwhackers here are some pretty good tag team maneuvers.
That was a low blow. Did you see that, Lane?
I saw a shot to the stomach, and you'll see the Gigolo is holding his stomach. It wasn't low. And, you know, speaking of that hospital for sick children, Ted, next week here, we will have the address for those of you who would like to donate, contribute something to these sick children, by all means do so. I think it's a very worthy, worthwhile cause. The address will be here next week. And Ted, I think you should jot it down.
Well, you know what I think, man? I think you mind your own business. Speaking of business, we got some more business at hand. You know, there's some more qualifying matches that have been announced for the King of the Ring tournament.
Yes, there are. This Monday night on Raw, the bad guy, Razor Ramon, Ted, will face off against the martial arts expert, Quang. That'll be a good one.
That's right. And then next week on Superstars, oh, he blocked that shot. Look at that.
Nice tag team maneuver there.
Like I was saying, next week on Superstars, Mabel will face Pierre, who is the former tag team champion, and imagine to qualify for the King of the Ring. It'll be interesting to see how Pierre fares without his partner.
Look at that. Oh, Gigolo Jimmy Del Rey tried to mimic what the Bushwhackers did, but he just got field goal punted.
The Heavenly Bodies have pinned themselves.
Yeah.
Obviously, you can't do that. Well, I'm not quite sure. I know what's going on. I don't think the referee does either.
Boy, it is something else here. Looks like Luke just got caught, though, with a knee in the small of the back. The referee out of position, did not see that. And now, Pritchard and Del Rey working the lower back area of Luke.
You know, Stanley, a little earlier, we were talking about the upcoming qualifying matches still to take place in the King of the Ring tournament. There's one, the one coming up Monday night on Raw. I'm really looking forward to. Razor Ramon is going to face Quang. And I've been saying ever since his arrival in the World Wrestling Federation that Quang is up and coming. This is going to be a real test for Quang. I'm really looking forward to that match.
Well, I am too. You know why? Because I don't think this is going to be much of a wrestling match. I predict this will be a fight.
Here we go. Yeah.
Speaking of a fight. Shot in now, double team, double elbow, puts him down. Whoa, where's he going?
He's chasing him all the way back.
My goodness, Butch is chasing Cornette clear out of the building. But his partner, Luke, is paying the price in the ring. Well, the action is hot and heavy. And speaking of hot and heavy action, Big Apple, get ready. Because a WrestleMania Revenge World Tour is heading your way for two big
stars. Oh, there he goes. That's a moonsault off the top.
That's got to do it, Ted.
It's over. It's all over.
He's got the legs hooked. The heavenly body successful. Once again, here two big nights, two big tour stops in New York.
He's got that tennis racket. Oh, hit him in the back.
He's got Cornette's tennis racket.
He's chasing him out of the ring. Hey, get that thing away from him, ref. He's got no business.
Butch is wreaking havoc in the ring.
He's wreaking, all right. He stinks. I still smell sardines.
The aroma of sardines still heavy in the area. Get ready, Nassau Coliseum in Uniondale. The WrestleMania Revenge Tour autograph session. Don't miss this. Thursday night, May 19th, in the Nassau Coliseum, Mabel and Oscar from Van Elimination will be there. Ted, I want you to tune in to WBAB and WDRE for more information on the WrestleMania Revenge World Tour, because you and all the people that are tuned in could have a chance to win tickets to Nassau.
That's right. They're doing all kinds of giveaways. So don't forget, you know, the new lighting system, the new sound system. It's quite an event. And, hey, the card reads like a who's who in the World Wrestling Federation. I mean, Bret the Hitman Hart, Owen Hart, Crush, Lex Luger, Razor Ramon, Diesel. It goes on and on and on.
Three big title matches, and then 1 week from this Friday night in the Garden. Get ready.
Big Apple.
Remind you to tune in to Scott and Todd in the morning on WPLJ for your chance to win tickets to Nassau and Garden.
I was in sumo for 1 year, from November 86 to November 87. I got into it because it was an opportunity of a lifetime, a chance to do something that no other North American had done. My record was 24-0. That's also a record for any foreigner in sumo. My sumo name was Koto Tenzan. Koto is a Japanese musical instrument. Ten means heaven, and Zen means mountain. I came into the World Wrestling Federation and became even a bigger star than I could ever dream of being in sumo. As the saying goes, the rest is history. But the book's not closed yet, because I've got a lot to prove here in the WWF.
You know, the other day we're on a job, digging a trench. Afterwards, we go eat lunch. The thing has to have been about 6 feet wide, anyway, about 5 feet deep. Come back from lunch, all my guys and my crew were sitting over there yelling and screaming. They're going crazy. I thought somebody must have got hurt. So I go running over there, and what do I see? The Undertaker sleeping in the trench. Oh my goodness, I said to myself, my guys, what are we going to do? Get away from him. I don't know what's going to happen. We back up about 5 feet. He just gets up, walks through the woods, and keeps on going. Just vanishes, disappears into the woods.
I'm standing backstage right now with none other than Earthquake, the man that has agreed to face Yokozuna in a sumo match right here next week on Monday Night Raw. I want to ask you one question. Are you nuts?
What do you mean, am I nuts?
Yokozuna, I am going to accept the challenge of the sumo match. Next week on Monday Night Raw, I am going to show you who the big man in the WWF is. I'm going to kick your butt.
Oh, believe me, I'm not going to miss Monday Night Raw next week. Wait a minute, you know, they say earthquakes start with little tremors, and I think I feel a tremor now. Oh, that's just your knees knocking.
Yes, ladies and gentlemen, the one and the only World Wrestling Federation Heavyweight Champion, the Hitman, Bret Hart. The excellence of execution. A standing ovation for the Hitman. Challenging you to the one-on-one encounter at the King of the Ring on Sunday, June 19th. We're about 5 weeks away. But before we talk about that, let's talk about another challenge. Let's talk about the challenge, unquestionably, that you will encounter on the Worldwide WrestleMania Revenge Tour. Obviously, no longer in the shadow, if you will, your brother Owen. What about it?
Fully understand what my brother Owen is all about. It was my own mother that kind of put it all in focus for me. She told me what she thinks about Owen now. It seems like Owen was born bad with a desire to be good. But in my case, I was born good with a desire to be bad. I don't know if it's this right here, Owen, but I have a strong sense that it's this right here that has given me a whole different direction, and I look forward to stepping in the ring with you, Owen, and I guess we're going to find out not only who is the best wrestler in the Hart family, but we're going to find out who is the best wrestler in the world, period.
The imminent challenge of your brother, The Rocket. Let's talk about a monster. Let's talk about at the King of the Ring. Will you accept the challenge from the 7-foot Intercontinental Champion, Diesel? Taking on all comers. But how do you counter a man who is 7 feet, well over the 300-pound mark? How do you counter the tactics and skills of the Diesel?
Diesel, 7 feet tall. I know exactly what he's thinking because I've been there before. I was Intercontinental Champion at one time, and I know that he thinks that he's unbeatable, that he's just gonna walk all over me because he's 7 feet tall. But Diesel, you may be one of the biggest wrestlers that I've ever stepped in the ring with, but mark my words, sooner or later, I'll bring you down to your knees. And once I bring you down to your knees, I'll bring you on your back. And once you're on your back, there's only one road for you to go, brother, and that's in the sharpshooter, and Diesel in the King of the Ring. I guess we're going to find out who is the best in the World Wrestling Federation, because you'll be dealing with the excellence of execution. And I know you've got everything to gain and nothing to lose.
but mark my words, Diesel, you will go down.
Sunday, June 19th, the Gauls down. My name's Roddy Piper. This is my last day on the set of Tough and Deadly, new motion picture for Universal. But just before I leave, I got a couple more bottom lines I want to tell you. I heard Jerry the King Lawler say that I was an old relic, like Jurassic Park. I was a dinosaur. If I'm a dinosaur, Jerry Lawler, then I'm a Tyrannosaurus Rex. How'd you like to get stepped on by a dinosaur? Bottom line. Hey, Lawler, King Toady, this is a warning. Stay off the family, quit knocking the kids. It's a kilt, not a dress. Bottom line.
Earlier today, our cameras caught the million-dollar man, Ted DiBiase, showing up with his latest property, if you would, Nikolai Volkov. Let's take a look.
No. Don't touch the door. Very good. Volkov, get back here. Volkov, get back here and open this door. Volkov, in the future, when I give you an order, you jump. As a matter of fact, when you jump, you say, how high and when can I come down? You got it? Now you got a match to get ready for. Let's go. That, 3 feet behind me. 3 feet behind me. Come on, let's go. Come on, let's go.
Made in there. Listen to this. Let me just tell you this. He said time is quickly passing Yokozuna by. He's not the master anymore, and pretty soon he'll be humbled, and he'll be washing my back. Can you believe Earthquake would make a statement like that? Is he crazy?
You can bet he believes it. What a sumo match. Have you ever seen a sumo match here in the WWF before?
WWF, but I've seen sumo matches in Japan. Two huge guys trying to push each other out of a circle. What?
What is like you're going to see him here? I mean, the ropes are going to be taken down and someone could be shoved out of that ring. That would be a nasty fall. Who knows what's going to happen this Monday night?
No ropes?
We are back and we're ready for action. We're ready for this Monday night as well. The Earthquake squaring off against one-on-one the former WWF champion Yokozuna.
Oh, I can hardly wait till Monday night.
The sumo match. First ever in WWF.
Earthquake is going to get his comeuppance.
Oh, really?
You understand that word?
Yeah, AC. Oh, wait a minute. AC Corner. Quite the aggressor here. Coming off the rope now into the mighty Earthquake. And he can't budge him, but that's about all. Earthquake. Almost standing there in defiance. Corner.
No way. Are you kidding me? Yokozuna is so huge. He's so big. Earthquake's going to look like Harvey Whipple next to Yokozuna.
Really?
That's right.
I'm anxious to see it. I mean, we've never seen a sumo match before. And by the way, the rules are something that, well, they're a little different. In a sumo matchup, WWF style, the ropes are taken down off the ring, which means that, of course, if you're shoved out of that ring, I mean, someone could take a real, bad fall. And either it's the first one shoved out of the ring is the loser, or if, in fact, you happen to touch any part of the canvas, then you become the loser. Earlier on, we had an occasion to pick up these comments from Yokozuna, along with that big mouth Jim Cornette. They're really looking forward to the matchup this Monday night.
Earthquake, this Monday you meet Yokozuna in a sumo match with sumo rules, and you're going to find out after it's over that Yokozuna does mean grand champion. You're going down, Earthquake. You think Holyfield's got a bad heart? Wait till he gets finished with you.
We're back, and Earthquake pretty much, look out, here he comes. Oh! AC Corner having his problems.
Did Cornette sound confident or what?
Yes, he did.
I can hardly wait till Monday night. You know, I used to feel sorry for Earthquake. Somebody told me he had TB. Then I realized that meant two bellies. Can you imagine how he's going to look in one of those old antique sumo outfits? You know, with that loincloth wrapped around that big fat stomach of his? And get it. What would that look like from behind, huh?
What do you mean, behind?
Those two huge ham hocks there with that loincloth going
look
up.
Look out, and go! AC Corner just got a good look at those hams, as you call them. And I think you are referring to the Mawashi.
The what-y?
What's a Mawashi? Earthquake and Yokozuna square off in the more traditional sense. And one more time, look at this. Oh, my goodness.
What's a mawashi?
You know the mawashi. You were talking about the loincloth.
Wait a minute.
Whoa.
He said, what's he doing?
He's warming up. Oh, yeah.
His back. That's what he'll be doing.
You better evacuate the WWF because you can't survive the big one.
This fight wasn't last week?
Yeah, it was last week.
We open his pool. We pull the cover.
All of a sudden, out the woods, here he comes.
The Undertaker.
Walks through the pool. The pool's about 40 degrees.
Climbs up one side, gets up, out of the pool.
Walks away, doesn't say anything to anybody.
He's gone. Disappeared.
Vince McMahon, I got a question for you. Do you believe any of those people?
Of course.
Oh, my God. I wouldn't believe them if their tongues were notarized.
His owner.
Look at this. On his way to the ring right now, ladies and gentlemen. We saw them earlier pull up in the limousine. The million-dollar man, Ted DiBiase. And look, Volkov is 3 feet behind Ted DiBiase, just as he was ordered to be. But he's not happy about it. He's not happy about this relationship at all.
He should be. Oh, nickel and dime Volkov.
That's Nikolai.
He should be happy to get any scraps, any crumbs that fall off the table of the million-dollar man.
Well, I'm sure Mr. Volkov is pleased to be employed, but considering the hardship that he and his family have been through, but he does not like
hardship.
Yeah,
he's a poor, can't even pay attention. Look at him.
Wow, that is a beautiful, look at that, the million-dollar bout. Dwayne Gale to meet Nikolai Volkov. Volkov doesn't like taking orders from Ted DiBiase. I mean, he just plain doesn't like his boss. That's obvious.
Well, I bet he likes taking money from him.
Well, he obviously likes bringing the money home to his family, but no, he doesn't like taking money from Ted DiBiase. And you'll see Volkov, who is quite the aggressor. Nice maneuver! But at the same time, Volkov likes to be a bit more scientific than Ted DiBiase would like for him to be.
How long ago was it that Volkov was a big superstar here in the World Wrestling Federation?
Well, not that long ago. Over the hill.
Made all that money. And then what, he bought a lot of condominiums or something?
He was swindled. Let's just put it that way. He invested in someone whom he had trust, and unfortunately, he was swindled.
It's easy to trick the simple mind.
Oh, please. Let's talk about the New York City area, all right?
Yeah, let's do. New York and simple minds, they go hand in hand.
Please. Let's talk about the WrestleMania Revenge World Tour. Headed to the New York area this Thursday night in Long Island at the Nassau County Coliseum, and this Friday night in Madison Square Garden, the autograph session set up in both locations, ladies and gentlemen. When the doors open in Long Island, scheduled to sign autographs, Mabel will be there with Oscar. And then on the Madison Square Garden, signing autographs will be the new tag team champions, the Head Shrinkers, along with Alpha and Captain Louis Albano.
I can't wait. This Thursday and Friday night, I'm going to be first in line at both locations. I want to see if any of these guys can even sign their names.
Also, by the way, who knows? It could be two of you chosen to square off against each other in sumo suit competition.
I'll challenge any one of you kids out there to put on those sumo suits and face me.
Oh, too much. By the way, the loudest section of the night will be chosen, and PC Richard's son is going to give the loudest section a special gift certificate. Plus, who knows? Maybe you can be chosen as the guest ring announcer. Maybe you can be chosen as the guest flag bearer. Or who knows what's going to happen? Might even be chosen as a guest manager for a WWF superstar. All we can tell you is the WrestleMania Revenge World Tour this Thursday and Friday. Wait a minute, what's this?
What do you think it is? See, the million-dollar man is trying to show Nikolai and I Volkov how to do it his way.
From behind. And again, Volkov listing to Ted DiBiase. Dwayne Gill, however, capitalizing.
No, you're wrong. Volkov is not listening to Ted DiBiase. That's his problem.
Yeah.
He's trying to wrestle these guys like a wimp out there, trying to be nice. Nice guys finish last.
Oh, please. Volkov now with Dwayne Gill. And you sort of get the impression that Volkov's dander is getting up. Not because he's taking orders from Ted DiBiase, but because Dwayne Gill is obviously taking advantage of the situation.
Well, I'll tell you what, Volkov better start doing what DiBiase does. Oh, yeah, now there it is. That's what the million-dollar man wants right there.
One, two, and a victory for Nikolai.
Well, he does. You know, here in the WWF, there's been advisors, there's been managers.
those guys in the NBA or something, I'll show you something. I'll tell you what. Over the roof, off the payloader, bank shot off the wall, into the dumpster. Payloader! Yes, that's three. And if you think that was something, wait till Duke the Dumpster Drosy comes to the World Wrestling Federation.
Ladies and gentlemen, one-on-one, Lex Luger to square off against Double J Jeff Jarrett. What a matchup!
I thought I predicted Mabel. How is your... You better check your memory. I'm certain that my royal prediction was Mabel, but my royal prediction on Double J and Lex Luger is none other than... Double J!
And here is... Hey! Take a look, if you want, ladies and gentlemen. Double J, Jeff Jarrett, qualifying match. Do you go to the King of the Ring?
Hey, let's get first things first, Vinny Mac. Right here is the King of the WWF.
There you go.
But you've got a tournament, a big pay-per-view spectacular. Lex Luger, next week right here. You're going to find out, not only am I stronger than you, not only am I a better wrestler than you, but I'm also smarter than you. And you're going to find that out next week. Double J style. And Luger, don't you forget it. That's J-E-double-F. J-A-double-R-E-double-T. That's Double J now.
Next week, ladies and gentlemen.
Greatest wrestler.
Well, that issue of the WWF magazine, available on newsstands as we speak. I can't believe the Rocket saying that. His brother didn't make him wear anything.
Come on, Wayne. No, I couldn't have said it better. You know, Brett, sometimes the truth hurts, doesn't it?
Well, the truth this week, Ted DiBiase, is that this man right here, Quang, the martial arts expert, will face a 1-2-3 kid. And let me refresh your memory, because 2 weeks ago, right here, Quang and Harvey Whippleman, after Quang had already defeated his opponent, just were beating the stuffing out of him. I mean, uncalled for beating. And the 1-2-3 kid, who was scheduled up next, standing in the wings, saw what was happening. He came out and saved Quang's opponent from all kinds of injury. And a big Pier 6 battle ensued. And now the match has been signed. It is their feature match. I can't wait to see this. This will be some martial arts expertise as we see Quang take on the 1-2-3 kid.
1-2-3.
Yeah, well, 1-2-3 is what it's going to be, Stan Lane, but it's not going to be this punk kid. What you're trying to say is this snot-nosed punk stuck his nose in this guy's face. Hey.
Oh, yeah, they're wasting no time. They're going at each other.
Tooth and nail. Side headlock by Quang. Beat fired into the ropes. Big shoulder tackle. Puts the 1-2-3 kid down. 1-2-3 kid lightning fast. Drops down. Leapfrogs. Oh! Quang ducked under a spinning kick and then another. Wow, they are so fast. Look at these kicks.
Oh, right over the top.
Quang got caught. Right. Look at this move here.
Oh,
moonsault over the top rope. Wow. We knew this would be pandemonium and chaos, and it certainly is. This is great. 1-2-3 kid taking it to Quang.
Perhaps a bit too enthusiastic there and ran headlong into the boot of Quang. Here comes that Oriental mist, I'm afraid. What color will it be this week?
Well, I don't know what color it is, Stan Lane, but I sure hate to take a shot of that to the face.
Well,
and speaking of taking a shot to the face, the kid just got a shot there. He came in and had a good start, but I tell you what, I think he underestimated Quang, and he's taking a beating for it now.
Well, I doubt very seriously that the 1-2-3 kid would underestimate any opponent, but the fact of the matter is that Quang outweighs him by some 80-odd pounds.
Oh, wow. What a shot!
That was beautiful. Wow, what a crescent kick that was. And it took the 1-2-3 kid down.
Is this it?
It? Got a two count. 1-2-3 kid is dazed here this week.
It's like I said at the opening of this show, Stan Lane. There's only one martial arts expert in this match, and he's got the advantage right now. That's Quang.
Well, this crowd is chanting 1-2-3. You know, each and every week, every time I see the kid in action, he feeds off the crowd's enthusiasm. They fuel the fire inside the 1-2-3 kid. And that flame right now is flickering. But will it come up again? Will it be an explosion? The 1-2-3.
players. So far, things going his way.
Quang so precise with every kick, with every chop, with every thrust. I'm telling you, this guy really impresses me.
Obviously highly trained. Has a neck hole now, working the trapezius and the neck muscles. We've seen him do this many times. He starts off with this hole to wear down the muscles of the neck, and then he goes to that nerve hole.
Oh, here go these nickel and dime penny pinchers again, shouting for the kid.
Quite obvious who they're pulling for. They want the 1-2-3 kid to get with it here.
Well, you talk about them cheering for the kid. I'll tell you why, that can be a disadvantage as well. You can't depend on the people to get you up.
Oh, 1-2-3 kid's head slammed in the turnbuckle hard. He shot into the right far turnbuckle now. Here comes Quang. Oh, 1-2-3 kid move. Nice hip block takeover there. Quang with that nerve hole on the 1-2-3 kid.
I tell you what, the 1-2-3 kid's wishing he didn't stick his nose in this man's business at this point.
Harvey Whippleman enjoying what he's seen.
I'm kind of enjoying it myself. This punk, I'm tired of him.
Referee checking your head. No way, there's no way under the sun the kid's going to give it up here. I know him too well. He's got too much fire, too much determination to ever say quit.
Yeah, and a brain about the size of a peanut.
He's coming up. Hit the ropes here. Sunset flip attempt. Quang definitely trying to reach the ropes for leverage, but couldn't make it.
What's this hit? No.
Oh, got a cover.
Not enough. It'll take more than that to beat this guy.
That took it out of the 1-2-3 kid there. He's slow to come up, and he takes a boot right to the face for his effort.
That kid, y'all just go ahead and throw in the towel, buddy.
Quang back on the 1-2-3 kid. We knew this would be martial arts personified. It certainly is. Oriental style match most of the way. You know, Ted, speaking of Oriental style matches, this Monday on Raw, don't miss the big sumo matchup between the Earthquake and Yokozuna. I can't wait for that.
I wouldn't miss it for all the money in the world. Well, maybe for all the money in the world I would. But you know what Yokozuna means?
What's that?
In Japanese, it means grand champion sumo wrestler. And that's what Yokozuna is. I'm telling you what.
But bear in mind, the Earthquake, Ted, undefeated in sumo wrestling in Japan. He was 24-0.
Well, he's fixing to be 24-1.
Well, we'll find out Monday on Raw. The ropes will be taken down. It's going to be sumo style. And here the 1-2-3 kid is back to a vertical base once again. Drives an elbow to the midsection. Oh, come on, ref. Quang just raked the face of the kid.
It's top and cover. This is it. It's all over.
Over. The kid barely kicked out. Oh, that was so close.
Valiant move, kid, but not too smart. You're getting beat up bad.
I must say, I thought it was over right there. Ducks under him. Oh, look at that.
Oh, wow. Oh, again.
Just when you're ready to count him out. No. The 1-2-3 kid will surprise you.
Yeah, but Tech Quang is. Oh.
Blocked. Oh, the kid nails Quang with a right. The kid is so resilient. Yes. Series of roundhouse kicks. And then a spinning hook kick again. And Quang is down. Oh, look at the fire. Look at the intensity of the kid. Hit the ropes for Leverett. Oh, come on. Harley Whitman grabs the foot of the kid. That's a disqualification ref.
Oh, what a shot. There you go. There you go. We got him now. That's it. Count referee.
No. I can't.
One, two, three.
What can the ref be thinking? Harvey Whippleman blatantly grabbed the kid's leg.
Whang!
Oh, my, that is terrible.
The kid got his foot cut up on the ring apron. He's just trying to unhook his foot, Wayne. What are you talking about?
I can't. And look at this. What does Harvey Whippleman think he's doing?
Hey, get off of here.
The kid let die, Whippleman.
Hey, come on, referee. Get him off him.
Oh, no.
That's what you get.
Quang attacks the kid from behind.
That'll teach you. That'll teach you. Don't put your hands on the manager.
Now, look at this. This is the exact same situation that happened before.
enjoy this.
Why does the kid hooking? Harvey's taking his jacket off.
Yeah, this will teach a kid stick your nose in somebody else's business. Go ahead, Harvey, let him have it.
Look at that. This is so uncalled for. Harvey's hand kicking down. I love it. But Quang, the series of jumps to the kid. It's 2-on-1 here.
I wish I had a towel. I'd throw it in for him.
Happened the other day. I'm out here pumping gas. I look down the street, see something coming, no big deal. I look up again, this big black hearse coming down the road. Get this, on top of the hearse, the Undertaker was on top of the hearse. Now, he wasn't in the car, he was on top of the hearse. I got gas coming out all over me because I can't believe it. Drives by me and he vanishes.
I don't know about some of these Undertaker sightings. It's almost like Ripley's, believe it or not.
Well, I hope it's true.
Speaking of Ripley's, believe it or not, is this man, and let me make one Jerry Lawler, really a king?
Out of my eyes.
Let's listen in.
I think that you people are repulsive.
You got to
be
ripping.
You know the meaning of the word repulsive?
I'm not looking at him. I'm just looking at him. Right now.
Get your dictionary out and look up the meaning of the word repulsive. As a matter of fact, you'll probably find your picture next to the word. And speaking of repulsive, I want to talk for a minute about Rowdy Roddy Piper, because you see...
Yeah, Piper's going to shut that mouth once and for all at the King of the Ring.
He can do it.
It is finally going to happen. I am going to get my hands on Rowdy Roddy Piper.
Yeah, right.
And it is going to be the greatest day of the King's life and the greatest day of the World Wrestling Federation, I promise you.
It's going to be his last day.
I did research on Rowdy Roddy. You see, I wanted to find out exactly when and, more importantly, why Rowdy...
Yes, indeed, you hear the chat.
I wanted to find out why...
Everyone looking forward to Hot Rod returning to action.
A dress. And I had to check way back. I had to go all the way back to when Rowdy Roddy Piper was 18 years old. And I found out he got drafted to be in the Army. So when it came time for him to go down and take his physical, he put on a dress and a pair of high-heel shoes. The Army didn't take him in, but the doctor took him out. Well, let me tell you something, Rowdy Roddy Piper. You're messing with a real man now. You're messing with the King. And when I get my hands on you, you will be the pits.
What a matchup that's going to be, ladies and gentlemen, in approximately 5 weeks. The King against the Hot Rod. We'll be back with more. We're back and we're ready for the sumo matchup, but the King is still in the ring.
But
somebody get the hook.
Tell us a little bit about your latest. This is actually your latest purchase. Is that right?
That's right, King.
You see, Volkov is penniless. He's flat busted. He's broke. Therefore, he works for the $1 million man.
You know what? If ignorance is bliss, this is Mr. Happy, and they say money can't buy happiness, but I guess it can.
Volkov not happy at all of being so-called owned by Ted DiBiase.
Everybody's got a price for the $1 million man. You got a price, don't you, King?
You got the money. I'm yours.
Exactly.
A man of integrity.
Volkov here has a price. I mean, he's working for me, and he doesn't even like me. You don't like me, do you, Volkov?
I hate you.
A lot of folks hate their bosses.
No choice situation.
You hate my
guess. I've been in it before. But you're broke and penniless. Therefore, Volkov. Like right now. Remember who's paying the bills now. Therefore, you'll do whatever I say. Because I hold all the cards and I hold all the money.
That's right. I love it.
That's right. Well, what do you think of how he looks?
Volkov has no choice, unfortunately.
You look like $1 million. He looks like 10 cents.
Well, I have solved that problem. You see, Volkov, for you to associate with the likes of me, it's beneath my dignity to have you walking around looking like that. So if you're going to work for me, first of all, that disgusting hat.
Well, go ahead. Go ahead. Hit it.
Disgusting hat.
He doesn't. I will.
I've got a little heart, King. I went out and I purchased you. I had special made for you a new outfit. That's right. It's going to come out of your pay, of course.
This is
first of all, the $1 million man is black and gold, so you got to get uniform, Volkov. Put those on. Show those to everybody.
What is this? Oh,
that is great.
Black and gold tights.
Those are beautiful. Oh,
property of the $1 million man.
Can you read?
Read this.
Don't put it on.
Put them on.
Don't put them on, Nikolai.
What did you
keep
say?
Keep your integrity.
He needs money, Vince McMahon.
Who not that pays badly. The bills?
Volkov has to think about his family. He has to think about...
He's hesitating.
Oh, well, he's going to do it.
Family first. Seen it before.
That's right.
Yes, but look at this. DiBiase is humiliating Volkov intentionally.
A little clumsy, but he's getting there.
Wait a minute. What's...
Well, they look good.
Now turn around. Let's see it. Come on, turn around.
Property of the $1 million man.
Insult the injury.
Property of the $1 million man.
A lot of people
that's right.
have no alternative in life, but
that's right. That's next.
To work for someone that they don't like. However,
you got an American flag on one side and an out-of-date Russian flag on the other side. It's like you don't know which way to go. Take that disgusting jacket off.
I hope the money he's getting paid is worth this. I hope it's a bundle.
Hey. He better think about that, those little snot-nosed kids of his and that family at home, hadn't he?
What about your Russian parents still over there you're trying to support? You better think about them.
Little leverage, Vince.
No question about that. Volkov torn between what he really wants to. No, he's not going to do it. He's not going to do it.
Feed your family, Volkov, or not?
Oh, what a crossroad.
Look at this.
I'm getting chills.
DiBiase humiliating Volkov just because he has the money.
That's right. Take it off.
Where money lies, honor dies.
Look at the chest on this man.
Stay in him.
Former
Olympic lifter.
Forget about that disgusting hat. That's history. You're working for me now. And when you work for me, you do everything I say. Now, wear a tuxedo. You got to dress up. I got a tuxedo for you, Volkov. It's a tuxedo shirt.
Oh, boy. Yeah, these guys are having a lot of fun out here at the expense of Nikolai this week.
Put it on.
Nikolai Volkov representing the country of Russia.
And months, Volkov.
As an Olympic lifter.
Shoes.
Years ago at age 18, he military pressed 400 pounds.
Put it on.
Those weights were easier than what he's doing now. I'll tell you that right now. This is the hard part. No way out situation for Nikolai.
Volkov, one-time proud Olympic lifter, much like Mark Henry of the United States of America today.
He's working for me because he's got no other choice.
Oh,
turn around.
Obviously.
Look at the big cent sign. Look at the cent sign.
Oh,
$1 million man.
The height of humiliation.
Well, I'll tell you what. He still doesn't look like $1 million.
Disgusting with capital.
He doesn't look like $1 million. But at least he looks like he's got a little sense now.
Jerry the King Lawler and the $1 million man, Ted DiBiase, blatantly humiliating this once proud WWF superstar, a one-time tag team champion. As he holds the rope for DiBiase, I'm sure he would like to.
We're back, ladies and gentlemen. Look at his nose stuck in the air, would you? Look at this. Oh, here it comes. For the very first time, ladies and gentlemen, yes, it's Duke the Dumpster Trocey. Where'd he go? The dumpster on his way to the square. Wait a minute. Look at this.
Wrestling Federation, and I want to have a couple of words with you before your match. But before I do, hang on a second.
What is this now? What is this? Oh, now, no!
That's a little better. So,
what?
Oh, no! Look at that! Duke dumping the trash on the king! All right! He dumped the trash on the king! And here comes Duke with the... Duke the Dumpster Drosy! The King Jerry Lawler covered in trash, and why not? He's been talking trash. As it relates to Rowdy Roddy Piper, he might as well be covered in it. All right, here we go.
Oh, look at this. Mike Bell attacking Duke the Dumpster Drosy. Look at this. Bell has that. Look at the size of the dumpster. Mike Bell going to work. No, reversal now. Coming off the rope, the dumpster. And oh, what a clothesline on Mike Bell. And what is that smell? What?
Wait a minute. Can you believe this, McMahon? Move over. Let me in here. Look at this. Can you believe what that idiot did?
Yes, I can. I must say that is one of the great moments of television.
What are you talking
in
about?
In all of television.
He is going to pay for that. Nobody is going to dump trash on me and get away with it. Look at what is this on my royal robe?
Oh, what is that? Yeah. Oh, my goodness.
Oh, my.
Take a look at this, if you would. Posters 10. Yes, it's the 10th edition of the Poster Magazine. And this time we're featuring 8 action posters of Bret Hart, Doink and Dink Double J, Jeff Jarrett in a Lundra Blaze, conspicuous by his absence. You're not in it, King.
I'm not in the Poster Magazine?
Nope. Uh-uh.
Well, then I can assure you that it's only fit for lining garbage cans.
Yeah, right. That clothespin, only that maneuver, would you? That clothespin on your nose obviously incited the dumpster.
Well, look at him. He reeks. Look at how filthy that slimy hair is in his clothes.
Well, he's not ashamed of that. I mean...
Well, he should be.
Well, why should he be ashamed of it?
He's filthy, that's why. If he starts sweating, he'll cause a mudslide. Look at him.
This is his very first appearance here in the World Wrestling Federation, ladies and gentlemen. The debut of Duke the Dumpster Drosy.
What are you laughing at? Don't try to pretend you can read.
I beg your pardon?
You heard me. I just ought to get up and go right down there right now.
Yet to come, ladies and gentlemen, this week we're going to see the Head Shrinkers in action. And, of course, the big news, Double J, Jeff Jarrett, one-on-one with Lex Luger in the King of the Ring qualifying matchup.
Well, listen, while you're talking about big news, I'm going to go ahead and let you in on a little secret right now. There's going to be a huge surprise a little bit later on, courtesy of the Million Dollar Man.
What sort of surprise? Understand you have some sort of surprise for us this Monday. What's that about?
What is this? What is this stuff?
Whoa,
on my road?
Oh, look at that maneuver. And a cover. And a count in. A victory for the first ever appearance of Duke. Look at him, see him rubbing his hands, getting the garbage off.
Right, you're exactly right. He's the only guy I know that's got a pet cockroach on a leash.
So, Hitman, you've accepted the challenge of Big Daddy Cool, and I knew you would. You see, I counted on it. Because you've always been a wrestling champion. You've dodged no one. But when I watched the monitor, you told Vince McMahon, yes, I'll take on the Big D. I think I noticed a hint of apprehension in your voice. Because you know you've never faced anyone with the size, the strength, and the agility of the Big Diesel. So at the King of the Ring, Bret Hart, you put your belt on the line. Against an enigma, a 300-pound juggernaut. Yes, Bret Hart, soon, the new world champion, Diesel. I can live with that, can you?
Champion versus champion. Diesel, newly crowned Intercontinental Champion, and I know exactly how you feel, because I've been there before. And you being 7 feet tall, I bet you feel real unbeatable, real powerful, and I think that you really believe in your heart that you are going to walk all over me in the King of the Ring and win the World Wrestling Federation Championship belt. And the best part about it for you is your belt isn't on the line. You've got everything to gain and nothing to lose. But Diesel, between now and then, I want you to think real hard every night. Between now and the King of the Ring, have you got what it takes to get past the excellence of execution? Have you got those years of experience to walk all over me? And the answer is no. Diesel, you may be one of the biggest wrestlers that I've ever stepped in the ring with, but mark my words, in the King of the Ring, you will go down.
Come on.
somebody else, King? See, I heard what you said about me being raised at the hospital for sick children. Yeah, I spent some time there as a kid. The point of the matter is, I need the help of the WWF wrestling fans. You see, all the donations that you're giving are going directly to the hospital. There's no middleman here. I made sure of that. You fight for the kids. I'll fight for you. As far as winnings go, the king called me a dinosaur. He called Piper's Pit Jurassic Park. Well, Jurassic Park was the biggest film ever. I'll take that compliment.
Most folks don't realize how big I am until they get in the ring with me. Take a look into my eyes. Then you're going to realize what you got yourself in.
I was working the other day. It was lunchtime. It was really, really busy. I'm serving customers like usual. I look up, and there he was, The Undertaker. I mean, this guy was huge. So, of course, I say, may I help you? This guy wants 6 dozen coffin-shaped donuts. Coffin-shaped donuts? I don't know if we have any coffin-shaped donuts. Then I thought, the eclairs, they're coffin-shaped. So I get him 6 dozen coffin-shaped eclairs, and I give it to him. Then I'm looking at this guy, I'm like, wow, this guy looks really, really tired. So of course I figure I'll give this man a cup of coffee. So I look at my selection, small, medium, large. I mean, come on, this is not gonna be good enough for a guy that size. So I thought, I got a thermos in the back that I could fill up with coffee. So I run back there, I fill this thermos up with coffee, I come running out, and he's gone. He's gone. He disappeared into thin air. I ask everybody, what happened to The Undertaker? No one knows a thing, he just disappeared.
What would a man of my resources be doing in a place like this? A cemetery. Well, if you think about it, the $1 million man has a lot in common with dead people. Dead presidents, that is. The way I see it, Paul Bearer can't find The Undertaker because he doesn't have the resources. However, I'm going to find The Undertaker, and when I do, he'll be mine once again. Because dead or alive, everybody's got a price for the $1 million man.
Welcome back, everyone, to more WWF Action. Vince McMahon along with Jerry. What is so funny?
What is so funny is the fact that the self-made man, Lex Luger, your man, has been eliminated. That's a side splitter, isn't it?
Right now, let's bring on an individual who next week will be in a King of the Ring qualifying matchup. Here comes the 1-2-3 kid.
Oh, no!
Who squares up, ladies and gentlemen, against Adam Bomb. What a matchup that's going to be.
Oh, that's going to be even funnier.
All right, here he is. 1-2-3 kid, perhaps in the King of the Ring tournament. What does the King of the Ring tournament mean to you?
Gus, you know, Mr. McMahon, to be in the King of the Ring, it'd be like a dream come true. You know, I mean, Gus, the best wrestlers in the World Wrestling Federation are in the King of the Ring. And I know I got to go through Adam Bomb to make it there, but I'm going to give it my best shot.
That's right. You got to go through Adam Bomb, kid. Adam Bomb. Do you know what we're talking about? Hey, let me direct your attention. Turn around there. Don't turn sideways. They can't see you. Spin around and look at this video screen right here. This is what Adam Bomb is all about.
Strongest man in the World Wrestling Federation, but I think I have the speed and the agility that I could possibly pull off an upset next week. I've done it in the past, and hopefully I'll be able to do it again and make it to the King of the Ring.
All right, best of luck to the 1-2-3 kid. Thank you very much. Next week, meeting Adam Bomb. What is so hilarious?
Adam Bomb against the kid.
The score will be settled. There's the bell. Here they come now. It'll be a match to remember. The 1-2-3 kid and Sparky Plug.
Tandem pit stop plunge.
chance he's going to be a turkey shoot.
Well, that remains to be seen. I will give you this, though. This gentleman right here, who hails from Three Mile Island, Adam Baum, he is huge. The 1-2-3 kid and Sparky Plug will definitely be grossly outweighed in this contest.
Outweighed, outmaneuvered, outmatched. They're real quick, all right. If they were quick as they should be, they should head for the dressing room now.
Well, that remains to be seen. There's an old saying, you know, it's getting ready to come to a head, and it certainly will momentarily, because these two tag teams are bitter enemies. There's no love lost here, believe me.
Well, you know, there's another old saying, Lane.
What's that?
If you're going to dance, you got to pay the fiddler. It's time to pay.
Well, I don't look for any dancing, but I do look for some expert wrestling, some martial arts expertise, and perhaps some fisticuffs before this one is all over. Look at there. Already a show of power by Quang. Quang probably outweighs Sparky Plug by some 35-odd pounds. But Sparky Plug has that quickness. Side headlock now by Thurman. Got it cranked in good, being shot off to the ropes now. Quang drops down. Oh, nice leapfrog by Quang. Oops, look at there. Sparky Plug ducked under that spinning hook kick and slams Quang. Oh, yeah. And sunk in a deep arm drag. You know, Ted, obviously, Sparky Plug has been watching film, and he was prepared. He was ready for that martial arts move and ducked right under it. Nicely done.
Well, he has the advantage right now, Lane, but just keep watching. Believe me, things are going to change in a hurry.
Working on that big, thick, well-muscled arm now of Quang. Being shot in for the right one. Oh, wow, just took an elbow right to the jaw. Oh, there's that knife edge thrust we've seen so many times before.
As I was saying, things change in a hurry.
Anything can happen in the World Wrestling Federation. Tide of battle can change dramatically from one moment to next. Oh, look at there. Nice drop toe hold. That's what you must do when you face someone who is that much bigger than you. You must take him off his feet. Bring him down to the mat. Make him the same size you are.
Nice move. Didn't last long.
Well, Adam Baum is so strong, so powerful. Oh, putting those big boots right into the solar plexus of Sparky Plug. Now being fired in. Irish whip. Ducks under a big right there. Oh, attempted a flying body press, but just caught in the clutches of Adam Baum. And what's this going to be?
Oh, backbreaker.
Oh, right in the kidney area. You know, Adam Baum, he is just huge. You don't realize how large he is until you get up close to him like we are right now. Awesome. Big elbow there. Puts the man from Talladega, Alabama down on his back once again. The tag is made. So far, Quang and Adam Baum tagging in and out.
So far, Quang and Adam Baum in control. Right, Lane?
It looked like for a second there that Quang was preparing to maybe spew that miss, but didn't have a chance because the quickness of Sparky Plug raised his head again, and he made the tag to the 1-2-3 kid. Oh, and already they are chanting for the kid.
Like I was saying, Lane, take a look.
Kid wasn't prepared for that. Went to lock up and took a knee right to the midsection. And now Quang is having his way in the turnbuckles with the kid. Look at this move. Oh, wow. Mexican-style arm drag. Oh, oh, series of roundhouse kicks. And there's that spinning back kick. And that took Quang one of the two. And a spinning hook kick. Put Adam Baum down, too. Watch out, kid. No, no. Kid perhaps preparing for an aerial maneuver, but turned his back to Adam Baum. That was a big mistake. But look at this now. Once again, the speed, the quickness, the agility of the kid pays off. And he's got both of Harvey Rippleman's men on the outside. A little bit of animosity here.
Come on, you guys. Don't fight amongst yourselves. Come on now.
Ho-ho!
Calm him down. Calm him down, Harvey.
Harvey has his hands full with these two, believe me. Back, and there's so much action going on. We can't bring it to you on one screen. This is our new double feature.
You see that drop kick?
Wow.
Drop kick in the back.
Action non-stop here. Look at this. You're seeing the replay on the left.
And they're fighting on the floor, okay?
Oh, look at this move.
Over the top rope. Did you see that move?
Oh, unbelievable kick. But a martial arts expert, Quang, took the kid over the top rope and to the floor. Oh, my.
There it is. There it is. There's the mist.
That mysterious green mist as Adam Baum just clotheslined the kid on the outside. So much is happening. So much going on here. You know, go ahead, Ted.
It's obvious, Stan Lane, that Quang and the Adam Baum. Oh, what a thrust.
ass kicked. They haven't worked as a team together. Therefore, a little argument on the floor.
Two count. Oh, no.
But they're obviously in control of this match.
Well, I'm starting to say early, you know, and look at the early onset of this, that, you know, Quang and Adam Bomb have not worked as tag teams very often. They've always been involved in singles competition here in the WWF, and they didn't have their act together, so to speak. They weren't that synchronized early on, but now they have things going their way.
I'll say, did you see that shot?
Awesome side suplex by Adam Bomb.
Hey, if I tell you it's going to happen, Lane, you can take it to the bank. I told you.
Whoa!
Wow, steady drop kick by Adam Bomb.
Oh, my. That is so impressive. You know, I've always heard that a good big man will always beat a good small man, and that's the case right here. We're seeing. Look at him using that quickness. He's got him in some corner.
Oh, not enough. Not enough.
Did not have the strength to hold Adam Bomb for a fall. It just took a big elbow right to the mush.
Well, you're going to have to admit, Lane, I told you what this match was going to be. It was going to be a disaster. It is a disaster for the kid and the punk.
Well, it's not over yet, so don't count your chickens. But I'll tell you what, Adam Bomb and Quang, once again, with those quick tags, they are keeping the fresh man in there. The 1-2-3 kid needs to make a tag to Thurman Sparky Plug.
I love this. This is humiliation at its finest.
Once again, the chant for the kid. 1-2-3. The kid ducks under a thrust.
Oh, did you see that?
Did you see that? Took a hook kick right to the forehead, and he is down and not getting up. This lateral press here.
Oh, my.
2.5.
I can't believe it. I can't believe he kicked out.
1-2-3, kid, so resilient. Never say die attitude of the kid. But he is in a bad way here, and he's desperately to make a tag.
Slam.
Big power slam by Quang. Got a cover.
Well, I can't say much for his brains. At this point in time, it's time to throw in the towel.
Kid trying desperately to tag, but it is in vain. Just does not have the power to overcome Quang and Adam Bomb right now.
What are they doing now?
Referee calling for the break here. They have up to a 5 count to get out.
Oh,
Adam Bomb missed again. Kick. Here's his chance, though. He needs to get over there.
Come on, get up.
He needs to make the crawl and get over there. Tag, Sparky Quang.
Come on, Quang, meet the tag.
Quang's trying to stop him. No, tag is made. Oh, yeah, let's see what's going to happen now. Sparky Plug opening up with both barrels on Quang. Big body slam. Adam Bomb coming in and is met by a boot, couple of right fists, and a drop kick. Sparky Plug is cleaning house. It's like spring cleaning here. Talladega, Alabama style. Being fired into right now. Reversal by Quang. Ducks under a hook kick. What's this gonna be? Oh, look at that! Adam Bomb just got kicked inadvertently.
No! No, I can't!
No!
Woo-hoo!
Oh, Bomb, just see that!
I can't believe that happened.
Quang has Sparky Plug hoisted up, spun around at Sparky's foot, hit Adam Bomb right in the face.
Wait a minute. What's going on?
Harvey Rickman appears to be blaming Adam Bomb for what happened.
Explain it to him, Harvey. Come on, don't let him.
Harvey Whitman is choosing sides here. He's trying to calm down Quang, but he's all over Adam Bomb. Look at this.
Well, obviously they're blaming each other. Harvey, explain it to him. Tell him what happened.
No, look. Now Harvey's patting Quang. He's blaming Adam Bomb. He's shaking his finger at Adam Bomb's face. They're both blaming Adam Bomb. How can they do that?
Well, obviously, Quang and Harvey feel like Adam Bomb reeled off the rope and hit Quang, that it was intentional and not a mistake. Well, he's reading the riot act. He's leaving ringside.
Well, let's take a look at the replay and see what did happen.
There he goes up in the air. There's Sparky Plug. Hits Adam Bomb. Bomb comes back up. Bang. Hits Quang. It was an accident.
Adam Bomb shoved Quang. And that caused Quang to lose his balance. And that caused him to lose the match. Sparky Plug pinned him. I love it.
Ladies and gentlemen, my guest this week is the man who is directly responsible for Lex Luger not participating in the King of the Ring tournament this year. He is one of the most ruthless men in the World Wrestling Federation. Accompanied by his manager, Mr. Fuji, here is Crush!
Well, this man right here, the Kona Crush, I can't believe what he did during that qualifying match for King of the Ring between Lex Luger and Double J Jeff Jarrett. Crush came down the aisle, grabbed Lex Luger, and crashed Lex's face into those steel steps. I mean, where does he get off sticking his nose in like that?
Now you're going to talk about somebody sticking their nose. goes to somebody else's business.
Yeah.
Now it's a different story. Well, what it is this. Lex Luger didn't stay focused on the problem at hand, which was Double J. He took off, chased this man back down the aisle. That was his fault. He took himself out of qualification for the King of the Ring tournament.
Well, let me ask you, if someone came and rammed your head to steel steps, wouldn't you chase him down and try to pay him back too? I think you would. I know I would.
It depends on what would be worth more. And obviously, what would have been worth more and more money is to stay where you are and keep focused on the match at hand. All it is Lex Luger, as always, crying and bellyaching.
Do you realize what it would mean to any World Wrestling Federation superstar to be crowned the King of the Ring? Well, you cost Lex Luger his chance, who, by the way, was considered by many the favorite to win this year's King of the Ring tournament. Now, if anyone would have a reason to want to seek revenge on you, don't you think Lex Luger would be that man?
Let me tell you something right now. Let me tell all you people out there something. Shut up when I'm talking! Listen here. Losing his chances of entering the King of the Ring is the least of Lex Luger's problems right now, brother. That was just an attention getter. Because Lex Luger, you have to step into the ring with Crush on this worldwide WrestleMania revenge tour. You know, Ray, they say good things come to those who wait. Well, me and Master Fuji have waited a long time for this opportunity, Lex Luger. And when the opportunity came around, I kicked the door in. So Lex Luger, Mr. Made in the USA, I'm standing right in your doorway at 6'7", 320 pounds of your worst nightmare. Because, brother, I hate everything you represent. I hate everything that you stand for. And most of all, I hate your stinking guts.
Well said.
Well, one thing you will hate, Crush, you'll hate it when the man made the USA gets his hands around your neck. We'll be right back with an Undertaker signing. Oh, I can't wait for this.
Let's see, what do you think about when you think of the Head Shrinkers and Afa and Captain Lou Albano? Four minds without a single thought? Terrible table manners. The World Wrestling Federation Tag Team title. And at the King of the Ring tournament, the belts are going to be coming home to Yokozuna and Crush, me and Mr. Fuji. So, Head Shrinkers, Afa, you better curtail those cannibalistic tendencies. Because right here, brother, you're going to find a couple of grade A USDA choice pieces of beef that are just a little too tough to chew on. We're taking those belts.
Bonsai!
Rowdy Roddy Piper, it's finally going to happen. You and the King, head-to-head, one-on-one, at the King of the Ring tournament. I've waited a long time for this, Piper. You know, you used to stand out here in that Piper's pit and try to convince people that you were real tough, all the while you were wearing a dress. Well, now you're going to have to face a real man. You should have stuck to making movies in Hollywood, Piper. At least all your movies had a happy ending, because everybody was glad when they were over. Well, I'll tell you what's fixing to be over. Your wrestling career, when I get through with you at the King of the Ring.
We're back, and ladies and gentlemen, right here next week, Native American Tatanka to meet the Gigolo Jimmy Del Rey. I believe that to be the final qualifying matchup for the King of the Ring right here next week.
The final qualifying match for the
and
King of the
just
Ring.
Just who will the King, Jerry Lawler, have as his guest next week? We saw the melee that occurred out here earlier on. I believe the King is standing by. Jerry Lawler, can you hear us?
Unfortunately, yes, I can hear you, McMahon, and I can hear you too, Macho Man. Hey, Macho Man, hold on to your hat. Or better yet, throw that silly hat away and keep your head in it. But listen to who my guest is going to be next week. The King's Court to end all King's Court. I can't believe. But it's signed, sealed, and it will be delivered next Monday night. The Hitman, Bret Hart, the man with the Jurassic Park parents, will be right here as my guest on the King's Court. Can you believe it?
Yeah, we can believe it.
I'm excited. That's unbelievable. Unfinished business. The Hitman has got with the King, Jerry Lawler.
Well, speaking of news, we're just about ready to make news, ladies and gentlemen. Yes, the King of the Ring qualifying matchup coming at you. Harvey Whippleman's Atom Bomb squaring off against the 1-2-3 Kid. And I must say, Harvey seemed quite confident, King, when you spoke to him earlier.
Well, you know, he exudes confidence, just like some jerks like Razor Ramon. I don't know what it is. What is it you say?
Machismo.
Whatever that is. But anyway, confidence was just coming out of Harvey Whippleman. He knows that the 1-2-3 Kid, he doesn't have a ghost of a chance against a guy like Atom Bomb.
A ghost of a chance?
Did you get that?
Yeah, I got it. Who knows? Maybe the 1-2-3 Kid can pull off one of his world-famous upsets. We'll find out when we return. Welcome back, everyone, to our WWF Action. This arena about ready to get real hot indeed. Yes. Who knows? There might be an explosion. And here comes the young man who can do it. The King of the Ring qualifying matchup. This is one of the final slots to be filled. Will the 1-2-3 Kid advance? Will he be a part of the King of the Ring, or will it be his opponent? That man, Atom Bomb.
Well, you know where I got my money, don't you? Anybody that associates itself with Harvey Whippleman is my kind of guy. Harvey is so smart. He's brilliant. I love him. You know, when he was a kid, he was in the Boy Scouts. He used to walk old ladies just halfway across the street. I loved it.
Yeah, you would.
What?
Look, Harvey, by the way, and Atom Bomb returning from a tour of where? Over in Asia.
Well, no. There's no truth to the rumor that Atom Bomb has been seen in North Korea.
That's not true. Maybe they could keep Harvey over there. Lock up now with a Kid. And the Kid cannot match the brawn. He cannot match the strength of Atom Bomb.
Why not? He looks like a match.
The 1-2-3 Kid being pummeled to the buckle. Atom Bomb setting him up. Atom Bomb! Of Atom Bomb, notwithstanding his brawn. Oh, here we go. Who is
already?
The Kid got his shoulder up. It was close, and there you see a smiling Harvey Whippleman, who was not smiling, by the way, last week with Atom Bomb. That's another story. We'll talk about it a little bit later on. Roundhouse Right misses. The Kid comes up. Cross body. No, wait a minute.
Look, Atom Bomb thinks a fly landed on him.
He caught the Kid in midair and then raises a knee into the small of the back. Atom Bomb.
I know what you are about to refer to. What you're trying to make a mountain out of a molehill, so there's no use even mentioning the little misunderstanding between Quang and Atom Bomb.
Yeah.
Harvey assured me nothing to it, nothing to worry about.
Bomb with a Kid and snaps him off the top. Yes, again, it was last week, ladies and gentlemen, Atom Bomb and his tag team partner Quang teaming up. And apparently, Harvey Whippleman blamed Atom Bomb on the loss. Look at that snap suplex.
Yeah.
A cover. And a drinking. Oh, he kicks out again. Becoming a little frustrated now that he cannot put the 1-2-3 Kid away. He can't finish him off. Off the rail, back body drop.
I know what you're thinking, McMahon. I know you're just sitting there thinking in the back of that little pea brain of yours. Upset. Upset.
Here we go. Upset. No. Yes. What a maneuver by the Kid. Come on, Rap. Put the count on Atom Bomb. Count him out. Count him out. If Atom Bomb is counting out, the Kid wins the match. The Kid goes. Wait a minute. What a minute. Can you believe that? Feature, take another look at it now. Look at this. The Kid comes out over the top. And
have you ever seen that in your life?
No. Atom Bomb caught the Kid in midair. And look at this. What? Harvey Whippleman is working on the Kid on the outside as well.
Trying to help him back into the ring.
Help him back in the ring. Oh, wait a minute. From behind. Turn around. Atom Bomb. Bailing the Kid from behind. Atom Bomb. In complete control at the moment. He's the 1-2-3 Kid back into the ring.
Finish him off.
Perhaps not. Atom Bomb now.
advantage.
Look at the kid's giving up. I can hear it.
That may be a chokehold. Check that forearm. Check the forearm. Make sure it's not under the chin.
You can see.
Adam Ma and the King of the Ring. If he wins this matchup, it'll make for one of the more unusual matches you saw at the top of the hour. You saw Bebo J. Wait a minute. Stay with us. Oh, no. Did you see that? And now Bomb is simply punishing the kick.
And he deserved it. Don't you think? He had the audacity to come out here.
Here we go. To open. Down. Off the net.
The kid shot his mouth off too much talking about the upset.
Double J. Upset last week, ladies and gentlemen. Lex Luger thanks to Crush. Oh, wait a minute.
Champion versus champion, and it's only 3 weeks away, Diesel. And it'll be you and me facing off, and I know what you're thinking. You're thinking that maybe I'm a little intimidated by the fact that you're 7 feet tall, that you've walked over everybody since you've come to the World Wrestling Federation. But I got news for you, Diesel. I don't get intimidated very easy. Sure, you're big, but let's cut to the chase right here, right now. Diesel, sooner or later, I will bring you down to your knees. And once I get you on your back, mark my words, you can have the sharpshooter put on you. Your legs are just long enough and just right for me to turn you over in the sharpshooter. And once I do that, I guess we're gonna find out who the best there is, the best there was, and the best there ever will be.
You see, Jerry the King Liar, lawyer, I ain't no king. And if I could be, I wouldn't want to be. If I had time to, I wouldn't want to be like you. Now, Todd Pentengale, he's saying that we're trash talking, he called it. I live in a tough neighborhood, man. Tanya Harding lives here. Senator Bob Packwood, whatever the heck his name is. Tough neighborhood. And Rowdy Piper lives here. I live in Oregon. But wrestling fans, if you think that I'm trying to get attention and talk trash, you're wrong. The WWF phoned me and asked me to come fight. And I says, okay, I'll fight if you help the kids. So, Jerry the King Lawler, I don't want to be doing that trash talk that Pentengale talked about. I really am trying to help out these kids. And WWF fans, I'd appreciate it. And all those one-liners you're using, I suppose I could say I hear you had liposuction, they had to use a fire hose, but not interested in doing that. But the bottom line here is I could put a sandwich on my back and starve you to death. Please help the kids. Bottom line, I ain't no king.
I am the best there is, the best there was, and the best there ever will be. And you have the audacity to come up to me and tell me, Rocket, you've qualified for the King of the Ring. Tell me something I didn't know. And now they can't find an opponent for me for the first round. That doesn't surprise me either. They're all scared of the Rocket. But what I really want to know is who I'm fighting in the final round of the King of the Ring, because that man I'm going to beat, and I will be the King of the Ring.
Talk about strange calls. The other day, I get a call up on the thruway. Bumper-to-bumper traffic. Now, I've been towing for a long time. I figure, well, let me turn my lights on, go down a breakdown lane. I'll get ahead of all this traffic, see what's going on. Driving down the side of the thruway, I get up to where all these people are all standing around something. As I pull up, kind of afraid to get out of the car, I didn't know what to expect. I figure someone might get hit by a car. I look down, there's a body laying on the ground. All of a sudden, he just jumps up. It's The Undertaker. This guy was huge. He jumps up, stands on two of the cars, jumps over another one, jumps over the barrier, and just disappeared. Just disappeared.
Last week, you saw me, the million-dollar man, Ted DiBiase, in a cemetery. This week, I'm in a funeral parlor. Do you know what it smells like in here? Phew. Money! Lots of money! And like I said last week, dead or alive, everybody's got a price for the million-dollar man. Even The Undertaker. So it should come as no surprise to all you stiffs that I've made contact with The Undertaker. And soon, very soon, he will be mine once again. That's right, he will become the property of the million-dollar man. And when that happens, all the other superstars of the World Wrestling Federation will be resting in peace.
Technical difficulties, ladies and gentlemen.
Well, give him a microphone.
But not as much difficulty as Harvey's going to have next week. It's Twang against Adam Bomb. So long, everybody.
Ladies and gentlemen, my guest at this time has catapulted himself to the top of the World Wrestling Federation, unlike anyone has been able to do. He stands nearly 7 feet tall. Accepted your challenge?
You know, Ray, I knew Bret the Hitman Hart would fall for my ploy. He is the excellence of execution, and without question, one of the finest technical wrestlers this sport has ever seen. But above all else, Bret the Hitman Hart is a wrestling champion. He fights whoever makes the challenge. And when he told Vince McMahon, yes, I'll fight the Diesel, I noted a hint of apprehension in his voice. Because yes, Bret Hart, you know and I know that you have never faced anyone with the power power, with the strength, with the agility that Big Daddy Cool's got. In 3 weeks, Bret Hart, your nightmare will be upon you when the Big Diesel starts shifting gears, roars into the ring, and takes what's rightfully his, not only the Intercontinental Belt, but the World Wrestling Federation Championship Belt. I am the force of the 90s. Big Daddy Cool is here to stay.
On the King's Court, you're not going to believe this, but I am going to have as my guest, well, I'll give you a little hint. I don't want to say his name right now because actually it kind of sticks in my throat to say his name. But I'll...
Yeah, but whoa. There's no way you can top what you've done the last several weeks. No way. I mean, impossible.
Oh, yeah. You forget I am the king. But let me tell you this. The guy that I'm going to have as my guest next week is from Scotland.
No.
I'll give you a clue. Huh? He wears a dress.
You know me.
Anything, and he wears a T-shirt with the words Hot Rod on it. He's going to be my
wow
guest.
Piper here next week. That's great. Oh, yeah. I like it.